Now, the polls show a big spike in the Greens vote, which means potentially the election delivering us a groundhog day, a hung parliament, with the Australian Greens holding the balance of power in a minority Labor government. So joining us now is Senator Sarah Hanson-Young, Greens spokesperson for the environment, the arts, media and transport. Sarah, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Oh, it's wonderful to be here.
So how do you read the polls?
Well, look, as a politician, you're taught really early on, don't read the polls. Mm. Talk to people, listen to what people in the community are actually saying. But of course, what is being reflected out there is a deep frustration from people in the community that the system of the two major parties just isn't working for them. So we've got almost a third of Australian voters across the country now looking at either minor parties like the Greens or independents. People want a change. They're sick of the kind of dodginess and self-serving nature of the current government, and they're lacking that inspiration that comes from having a vision. And they're not getting that from the opposition and Anthony Albanese.
The Prime Minister's been saying that a hung parliament is just going to mean chaos. Is it going to mean chaos?
Well, look, is it any more chaotic than what has happened under the last 9 to 10 years under this government, changing leaders several times over, prime ministers several times over, the scandals that have come out of this government? You know, talk about chaotic. I think Scott Morrison's entire leadership has been chaotic. He wasn't even here in the midst of the bushfires, for heaven's sake. I think a minority government, actually in a hung parliament, would force political leaders to take on the issues that the community wants. It creates more diversity of voices. But, you know, like anything, and people know this in their own workplaces, right? When the boss invites other people in to provide ideas, you often get a better outcome. Mm. Everyone ends up getting something, they're happier, and people are committed to driving the reforms forward. The Greens are putting inspirational big ideas on the table, tackling the climate crisis, putting Medicare, putting dental into Medicare, allowing you to go to the dentist and pay for it with your Medicare card. Like, why can't we do that already? These are some of the big ideas that we're pushing, and we hope that in a minority government we'll be able to deliver.
Is it a six-point plan for the Medicare?
I'll tell you what, it's 1 point, and it's pull out your Medicare card and be able to pay that big bill.
Yeah.
Too many people miss out on basic health care like that because it's just not under the current system.
We were just talking about that before. Yeah. What do you make of that six-point policy? And the details and whether it should be known or
the
not.
Gotcha
you know,
moments.
The gotcha moments. Well, I must say, I think one of the cut-through moments in this campaign was when the Greens leader, Adam Bandt, stood there at the press club and, you know, was asked a gotcha moment, and he said, well, you could Google it.
Yeah.
voters get that these are gotcha moments, but what they really want is big ideas, and they want a vision. And that's why they're turning on to the Greens, because we are putting these big ideas on the table and we're being really upfront about the climate crisis. You know, in the midst of the pandemic, people have become more and more concerned about the state of our environment, the state of the world, the future of their kids, and they know that the climate crisis is here already. We've seen the floods in Lismore. The rain that you've all been living through here in Sydney.
What do you think about the rise of the teal independents who've got the backing of Climate 200? I mean, that's kind of encroaching on Greens territory.
Yeah, look, I think actually this is a really positive injection into this election, that there are more people talking about climate change and the environment and engaging people in politics than ever before. I think that's a good thing. Mm. And what we're seeing actually is that those teal independents are not in seats that are key to the Greens, but it's lifting the momentum for all of us.
Yeah. You're the Greens spokesperson for the arts as well.
Yes.
Just to ask you about that. Can you tell us a little bit about that and what you're trying to do?
Look, the arts was absolutely smashed in the midst of the pandemic. You know, gigs cancelled immediately overnight. Artists and creative workers have really been struggling. And we're the only party this election putting forward a comprehensive policy, from helping to get art and music properly educated at a school level, right through to supporting artists who are out there trying to do their job and perform. We need to make sure we look after our artists. We wouldn't have got through the pandemic if we didn't have wonderful shows to watch and beautiful music to listen to and great books to read.
And congratulations are in order, yep. Senator. You were married during an election campaign.
I know. Well, the most important event of the election campaign. Yes, married my new husband, Ben Oquist, on Easter Saturday. It was beautiful. And I tell you what, it just reminds you of what's important. Family, where we live, the planet we're all striving to protect. I'm pretty happy.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, Sarah Hanson-Young, good luck in the 2 weeks to go, 15 days to go.
Thanks for being with us.